Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, I'm explaining about miscellaneous exercise on chapter 9, sequences and series, question number 10, 11 and 12 solution. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Question number 10, the sum of three terms in geometric progression is 56. If we subtract 1721 from these numbers in that order, we obtain an arithmetic progression. Find the numbers. So here, now let us take the three numbers of geometric progression as a, ar and ar square. Now in the question, they have given that the sum of three terms in geometric progression is 56 and we have taken these three terms. So let us write the given values, that is a plus ar plus ar square is equal to 56. Then if we subtract 1721 from these numbers in that order, we obtain an arithmetic progression. That means suppose if we subtract 1721 from these numbers, then we get a arithmetic progression. That means a minus 1, comma ar minus 7, ar square minus 21, these three values are in arithmetic progression. This is also given in the question. Now here we have to find the numbers, that is n value we need to find out. So to find out the n value, see, first of all, suppose if there are three numbers which are there in arithmetic progression, let us say that there are three numbers ABC and these ABC are in arithmetic progression. Then the common ratio, that is the common difference between the two continuous numbers is equal, that is B minus A is equal to C minus B in the case of arithmetic progression. This is the common difference. Now we can write this one as, this B you can bring to this side. So B plus B is equal to C plus A. That is nothing but 2B is equal to A plus C. So this is the equation we have to follow in the case of arithmetic progression, if three terms are in arithmetic progression. So we got 2B is equal to A plus C. See, in the given values also, we have here three terms. One is A minus 1, AR minus 7 and AR square minus 21. And they have given that in the question, these are also in arithmetic progression. Now let us take these values as, one as A, another as B, another as C. Now write this value in this form, that is 2B is equal to A plus C. So 2B is equal to A plus C. B values I have taken as this one. So 2 into AR minus 7, that is equal to A. A is this one, A minus 1 plus C is this one, AR square minus 21. So multiply this to this, 2AR, 2 into minus 7, that is minus 14, that is equal to A plus AR square minus 21 minus 1, that is minus 22. Then this becomes AR square plus A, this we will bring to this side, minus 2AR, that is equal to this minus 22 we will take to this side, so 22 plus 22 minus 14. So we get here A minus 2AR plus AR square, 22 minus 14, that is 8. So let us take this one as equation 2 and this one as equation 1. Now here to simplify this one, just divide equation 1 by equation 2. Here we have equation 1 and here we have equation 2. So when we divide this one, we get here A plus AR square divided by A minus 2AR plus AR square, that is equal to 56 divided by 8. From this you can take A value out, which is common here in both the cases. So if I take here A out, we have 1 plus R square divided by then here we have, if I take A out, A into 1 minus 2R plus R square is equal to 7. Here A and A is, you can cancel. So we have here 1 plus R square. Then this value you can multiply with this one, 7 into 1 minus 2R plus R square. So 1 plus R square is equal to, multiply this 7 with these values. So 7 into 1, 7, then 7 into minus 2R, that is minus 14R, 7 into R square, that is 7R square. So we have here 7R square minus 14R minus R plus 7 minus 1 is equal to 0. That is 6R square minus 15R plus 6 is equal to 0. Now here we have to simplify this particular equation. We can simplify this one. So first divide all the values by 3. So we have here 6R square divided by 3 means that is 2R square minus 15R divided by 3 means that is minus 5R. Then 6 plus, divided by 3 means that is 2. Then 0 divided by 3 is 0 only. Next, simplify this one. Here we have 2, here we have 2. 2 into 2, that is 4. We have to get here 4, and when we add the values, we have to get minus 5. Such two factors are minus 4 and minus 1. Minus 4 and minus 1, if you multiply, you get here value 4, and if you add minus 4 and minus 1, we get here minus 5. So substitute the values. So 2r square minus 4r minus r plus 2 is equal to 0. From this you can take the common value as 2r, so we have the remaining value r minus 2. Then from this you can take minus 1 as the common value, then we have r minus 2. So we have here r minus 2 into 2r minus 1, that is equal to 0. Then r minus 2 is equal to 0, r is equal to 2. Then 2r minus 1 is equal to 0, 2r is equal to 1, and r is equal to half. So for the here we got the value, two values for r, that is r is equal to 2 as well as r is equal to half. Now we know the two values of r, just substitute these values in any one of these equation. So now I am substituting r is equal to 2 in equation 1, that is a plus ar plus ar square is equal to 56. So if I put here r is equal to 2, I get here a plus a into 2 plus a into 2 square, that is equal to 56. So a plus 2a plus 4a, 2 square is 4, 4 into a, that is 4a, is equal to 56. This becomes a plus 2a plus 4a, that is 7a, is equal to 56. A is equal to 56 divided by 7, so A is equal to 8. Now here we know that in the beginning case, the number of terms of geometric progression we have taken like this way, A, AR and AR square. So just put here A value, that is A is equal to 8, which we got just now, and the R value, that is 2 in this. So we get here A is 8, comma AR 8 into 2, comma AR square, that is 8 into 2 square. So we have the terms here 8, 16 and 32. So we got the numbers of geometric progression 8, 16 and 32. But for R we have got two values, so again we have to do the same process by taking R is equal to 1 by 2, that is half. So now substitute R is equal to half in equation 1. You can substitute this value either in equation 1 or equation 2, any equation you can take. So A plus AR square is equal to 56. Here put R is equal to 1 by 2. So A plus A into 1 by 2 plus A into 1 by 2 whole square is equal to 56. That is A plus A by 2 plus A by 4 is equal to 56. Here you can take the LCM as 4. So we have here 4A, 4A plus 2 into 2, sir 4. So 2A plus A divided by 4 is equal to 56. That is, this becomes 7A divided by 4 is equal to 56. So A is equal to 56 into 4 divided by 7, A is equal to 32. So now we have here A is equal to 32 and R is equal to half. Put these values in the terms of geometric progression, that is A, AR, AR square. So 32 comma 32 into half into comma 32 into 1 by 4, then 32, 16 and 8. Question number 11. A GP consists of an even number of terms. If the sum of all the terms is 5 times the sum of terms occupying odd places, then find its common ratio. So now the terms of GP we can take like this way: A, AR, AR square, AR cube, AR to the power 4, and the last term we can take as AR n minus 1. These are the terms of n terms of GP. Now in the question they have given that the GP consists of even number of terms. Even numbers are always represented as 2n. See here, suppose if you take n value, anything, it may be odd or even, 1, 2, 3, whatever value you put and multiply with 2, then you are going to get the even number only. So to represent even number, we use 2n terms. So now here they have given that the GP consists of even number of terms. So now for this, we are not taking n terms. Instead of that, we are taking 2n terms of GP. So the 2n terms of GP, we can write like this way: A, AR, AR square, AR cube, AR to the power 4, so on up to AR n minus 2, AR n minus 1. After that we have AR n, then again AR n plus 1, AR n plus 2, like that way. The last term is AR 2n minus 1, because there are 2n terms. If there are n terms, we write the last term as AR n minus 1. So now we have 2n terms, so we have to write the last term as AR 2n minus 1. Now in the question they have given that the sum of all terms is equal to 5 times the sum of terms occupying in odd places. So sum of all these terms, that is A plus ar plus ar square plus the last term is ar 2n minus 1. Sum of all 2n terms, this one is equal to 5 times the sum of terms occupying in odd places. See, in this the terms occupying in odd places means, see, this is the first term 1, that means it is the odd place term. Then 2, this is not included. 3, this is the third term. Then this is the 4. Then 5, this is the fifth term. Like that way, this one is the 2nth term and this one is nothing but 2n minus 1th term. 2n term means it is the even value and this one is the odd value. So now we can write for this as a plus ar square plus ar to the power 4 plus 1 up to the last term we can take as this one, not this one. This means it is the even value. So plus ar to n minus 1, n minus 2. Now here we have to find the sum, a common ratio. So here to find the common ratio, see, first of all, we will, this is there in the GP form, so geometric progression. So use the formula, sum of n terms of GP, Sn is equal to a into r to the power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1, where r value is greater than 1. See, in this case here, for this particular series, a is equal to a only, and the r value we can get, that is ar divided by a, that is equal to r only, and the n, there are 2n terms, so n is equal to 2n. Next here, in this case, a is equal to a and the r value is ar square divided by a, that is r square. Now substitute the values here, so that for this series we can write the sum as a into r to the power 2n minus 1 divided by r minus 1, that is equal to 5 into a into r to the power 2n minus 1 divided by r square minus 1. So that is, this becomes, see, this a and a will get cancelled. Then here, this r square minus 1, we can write like this way, r minus 1 into r plus 1, that is by using the formula a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. Then here, after cancellation, this and this will get cancelled and this will get cancelled. We have here 1. 1 is equal to 5 divided by r plus 1, that is r plus 1 is equal to 5. R is equal to 5 minus 1, that is r is equal to 4. This is the common ratio value. Question number 12, the sum of the first 4 terms of an AP is 56. The sum of the last 4 terms is 112. If its first term is 11, then find the number of terms. So here they have given the arithmetic progression. First, let us write the terms of arithmetic progression. We take the terms of arithmetic progression in this way, a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, like this way, so on up to the last term we can take as a plus n minus 1 into d. This is for n terms of arithmetic progression. Now in the question they have given that the sum of the first 4 terms of an AP is 56. So now let us take the first 4 terms of AP, a plus d, a plus 2d and a plus 3d, and make the sum of this. So a plus d plus a plus 2d plus a plus 3d, that is equal to 56. This is given in the question, and also they have given the first term. The first term is equal to 11. Now here, this we can simplify. This becomes 4a plus 6d is equal to 56. We know the value of a, substitute that value. So 4 into 11 plus 6d is equal to 56, that is 44 plus 60 is equal to 56. 6d is equal to 56 minus 44. 60 is equal to 12. D is equal to 12 divided by 6, that is d is equal to 2. So now we got the value of d. Next here in the question they have also given that the sum of last 4 terms is equal to 112. The sum of last 4 terms means, see, the last term is here a plus n minus 1 into d. Then the next term we can take as a plus n minus 2 into d. Then again the previous term we can take as a plus n minus 3 into d. Then the previous term of that is a plus n minus 4 into d. So the last 4 terms we have to write here, that is an plus an minus 1 plus an minus 2 plus an minus 3. See, if we have an, we write here n minus 1. So 1 less than this 1. So n minus 1 if we have means we have to write n minus 2. For n minus 2 we have to write n minus 3. For n minus 3 we have to write n minus 4. So now using this formula, that is nth term, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, we can write all the last 4 terms. That is a plus n minus 1 into d for this, then a plus n minus 2 into d, then a plus n minus 3 into d, plus a plus n minus 4 into d. That is equal to 112. This is given in the question. Now simplify this one. 4a plus here we have d out in all the terms. So you can write this one as you can add all these terms. N minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 3 plus n minus 4 into d. That is equal to 112. That is a value we know that is given in the question 11. Substitute that value 4 into 11 plus this becomes n and n 4n minus 10 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 minus 4 minus 10 into d value is already we know, just we got that, so that is d is equal to 2. Put that value, that is equal to 112. So 44 plus 8n minus 20 is equal to 112. 8n plus 24 is equal to 112. That is 8n is equal to 112 minus 24. 8n is equal to 88. N is equal to 88 divided by 8, so n is equal to 11. So the number of terms is equal to 11. Thanks for watching.